Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in managerial accounting. And in this video, we're going to be discussing the concept of variance analysis. We'll start off by going through what variance analysis is and define the difference between favorable and unfavorable variances. Next, we'll talk about how companies can use it as a tool to continuously improve operations and look at a couple of specific examples along the way. Understanding this concept can help companies manage their finances more effectively and make smarter, long-term business decisions. So let's get started. Have you ever created a monthly spending budget for yourself and then realized after the fact that you spent way more than planned? I know I definitely have. When this happens, we may want to go back to the drawing board and investigate where we overspent and think about how we can improve going forward. Companies go through this very same process on a regular basis. In order to plan for future operations and control spending, most companies produce monthly budgets, which they can use as a tool to evaluate their performance. At the end of each month, this allows them to compare their actual results to their budget and pinpoint the areas that didn't go as expected to plan. This is the variance analysis process in action, where companies identify specific differences or variances. This allows organizations to investigate areas of concern so that they can improve going forward. Variance analysis ultimately shines a spotlight on the differences between a company's budgeted and actual financial performance. There's two key categories of variances that emerge during the process. Favorable variances occur when the result has a positive impact on a company's profitability. This would occur when a company earns more revenue than expected or spends less on operating costs than they planned. For example, let's say a company budgeted to spend $1,000 on direct materials. However, they actually only spend $800. The $200 difference between the budgeted value and the actual result would be the variance. In this case, since the company spent $200 less than they planned, this would be considered to be a favorable variance. Unfavorable variances occur in the opposite circumstance, when the result has a negative impact on the company's profitability. Let's go back to the previous example where the company budgeted to spend $1,000 on direct materials. If something didn't go to plan and they ended up spending $1,500 that month, they would end up with a $500 unfavorable variance. Anytime a variance exists, it's important that the company identify whether this is favorable or unfavorable so that they can make a decision on how to proceed. Determining these variances between the budgeted values and the actual results is only the first step. The next step, which can be even more important, is to spend time investigating the variances. In the example we just discussed, where the company had a $500 unfavorable direct materials variance, they'll want to get an understanding on the root cause behind this. If they can determine why they spent more than planned, then they can justify fixing the issue and spending time to ensure that the issue does not continue going forward. Could this have happened because the purchasing department bought the materials from the wrong supplier and paid a higher rate than planned? Or was it because the operations team used too much volume of material during the production process? These are the important types of questions that we'll need answering in order to improve things going forward. Now, it's a common misconception that companies need to spend time investigating all variances. While it would be nice to understand why each actual result differed from the budgeted value, investigating each variance can be extremely time-consuming and use up a significant amount of the company's resources. As a result, they'll generally want to come up with an approach that factors in the concept of materiality into the process. Variances that are immaterial or insignificant to the company's operations can likely be deprioritized, which frees up resources to spend time investigating more of the significant variances. Companies do this by coming up with a certain dollar value or percentage threshold that they apply across all variances. For example, they may choose to only investigate unfavorable variances of $1,000 or more, or variances that are 25% or greater than the budgeted value. While there's many categories of variances that can be analyzed, managerial accountants generally focus on a significant amount of their variance analysis on materials, labor, and overhead variances. For each of these categories of costs, the companies will first calculate the total budget variance, which is the difference between the actual cost and its planned cost. Actual cost is calculated by taking the actual price times the actual quantity, And planned cost is calculated by taking the standard or budgeted price, represented as SP on your screen, times the standard quantity. This variance can be further broken down into both price and usage variances in order to investigate where the issue is coming from. In general terms, price variance is the difference between the actual and standard unit price of material multiplied by the actual total quantity of material used. Usage variance tells us about how efficient the company was with their materials by taking the difference between the actual and standard quantity of materials and multiplying it by the standard price. Time for a quick exercise. For example, let's say a company actually used 95 pounds of material in production at a cost of $1.20. Their total actual cost would be $114. This would be the 95 pounds of material times $1.20 per pound. If they had budgeted to use 100 pounds of materials at a budgeted standard price of $1 per pound, their planned total cost would be $100, taking that 100 pounds times the $1 per pound. This means their total variance would be the actual cost of $114 minus their planned cost of $100, which equals a $14 unfavorable variance since they spent $14 more than they planned on materials. Now, in order for the company to understand what went wrong here, it's important for them to break this variance down further to determine whether it was the responsibility of the production department or the purchasing department. To do this, we would break down the $14 variance further into both price and usage variances. Calculating these variances would help us determine whether the issue resulted from the purchasing team spending more than expected on the price of the materials, or whether the production department ended up using more volume of materials than anticipated. The result to this analysis will give the company the tools they need to determine their course of investigative action to improve things going forward. And that brings us to the end of this video. Variance analysis is an extremely important tool that companies can use to manage and improve their profitability. It allows organizations to both pinpoint things that are going well in the company while also narrowing in on areas of improvement going forward. If you're interested in learning more about this topic or others, please feel free to check out our additional videos on many more related topics.